Soul Sessions. Soul Sessions. Yeah, yeah. Soul Sessions. We got the Soul Sessions.
Kia ora, talofa lava, malo elele, and welcome to Soul Sessions, a show celebrating gospel music in Aotearoa. On the show today, I'm joined by an award-winning New Zealand-born Samoan musician. Her sound is heavily influenced by R&B, soul, and gospel music, and she credits her dad for her love of music. Singing the well-known hymn, Great is Thy Faithfulness, here is Grace Ikenasio.
Great is Thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with Thee. Thou changest not, Thy compassions, they fail not. As Thou hast been, Thou forever will be. Summer and winter and spring and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses above, join with all nature in manifold witness to Thy great faithfulness, mercy, and love. Oh, great is Thy faithfulness, great is Thy faithfulness, morning.
What an amazing rendition of the hymn, Grace, Great is Thy Faithfulness. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much for having me.
You nailed that song. I just love those classic hymns.
Thank you.
Tell me, when did you start singing?
I started singing at around the age of 5 without intentionally knowing that I knew I could sing. Mm. I got singing lessons for a bit of time over the years. Okay. And it wasn't until maybe intermediate where I started to grow that passion of singing. Yeah. And really invest in myself in terms of that ability. And I started playing and singing in the church from that stage onwards. And have done it since.
That's so cool. And I'd love to hear about how you talk about your dad crediting you for your love of music.
So my dad, originally he was the one getting keyboard lessons when I was about the age of 6 or 7. Mm-hmm. And I used to just tag along with him to keyboard sessions. And I was really intrigued from what I was seeing, what was happening. And I wanted to be in there as well, learning myself. And at the time, it wasn't very affordable for both of us to get the lessons. And yes. So dad said, oh, hey, why don't you take up the keyboard lessons? Oh. And then later on in life, you can teach me.
Yeah.
And currently at the moment, he's still learning the keyboard and asks occasionally to teach him a few chords. And he's just doing really well for himself at home as well.
And from learning about the keyboard, you went to university and you got a Bachelor of Music.
Yes, I did 3 years at the University of Auckland studying pop music, majoring in songwriting.
Wow.
So piano is my main instrument. I grew up learning classical piano.
Yes.
So I did Trinity and Royal exams.
Oh, now for those of you who don't know what Trinity and Royal music is, so tell us, what is the Trinity and Royal School of Music?
Oh, so it's very prestigious in London, and it's where you get to learn about the classical history of music, as well as music from periods, the Romantic era, the Baroque era. Mm. But yeah, it was quite
intense.
Yeah, a lot of hours spent practicing scales and arpeggios.
A lot of scales.
Oral training as well. So a lot of that was involved. Yeah.
Well, we really look forward to hearing more about you on the show. It's great to have you. I'm here to hanuchu, which means to chat, in Rotsuman with Grace. Lovely to have you here.
Thank you, Sara-Jane.
Hey, let's tell Anoa about your heritage. Tell me a little bit about your culture.
My parents were born and raised in Samoa. My father was from the village of Safune in Savai, mm-hmm. and my mum comes from the village of Leulumuenga Tuai in Upolu.
And you were brought up here in Auckland?
Yes, born and raised in Auckland and a hearty representative of 828 Dale State, Avondale.
And you're a music teacher now as well. So where are you teaching music at the moment?
I'm teaching music at my old intermediate school, so Avondale Intermediate. I've been there for 10 years.
Yes.
And I haven't left the place because I love the community and I just have grown up with so many of the kids' parents.
Wow.
It's weird saying that, but a lot of the kids' parents I actually went to school with. But it's neat to connect and to still be with the people that I've grown up with.
Yeah. In your community, language must play a big part as well. And how do you use music and language with your teaching?
I'm still currently able to just speak the basics of our Samoan language, but hopefully in the future I'm hoping to endeavour into learning a bit more in depth about the traditions and everything that comes with the culture.
Yes.
My parents, they raised me to speak English, although we did have family members, like my grandparents, who spoke it quite, you know, it was natural for them.
Yes.
But my parents were heavily invested in making sure that we're learning English, so didn't really get the opportunity to learn too much Samoan, and we also attended an English-speaking church, so everything I learned, I basically learned from my grandparents or, you know, occasionally from my parents.
And so is learning the language infused with your music? That's part of your learning journey as well?
I would say so. So with today in performing a Samoan hymn,
yes,
that's a new venture for me. I've not really performed too many Samoan songs.
Yes.
I've maybe only recorded one song with the Coconut Poly Songbook.
Yeah.
And that was my very first, you know, performance of a Samoan song.
Wow.
So still learning and still open to, you know, picking up more of our language through the music.
And it's all about that journey of exploring how we can use our language and bring it into our music.
Yeah,
and
absolutely.
I'm sure a lot of our audience is really keen to hear the next song that you're about to sing for us. So please introduce it for us.
The next song we will be singing is an arrangement of Whaawhetai Lea Tua featuring Christmas Ropati on the guitar.
Ilona lo lena
To Hanuchu here at Soul Sessions, and I have Grace Ikenasio with us today. Grace, how do you feel about gospel music? What is it as a genre that you love about it?
I think that speaks to more than just one denomination, and I think it's a source of inspiration. It's definitely the first thing I would listen to if I'm in need of, you know, some help through some tough times or even just celebration. And I think it's just pure joy to have gospel and just in life in general.
And when you hit some of your notes, because they are so beautiful, how does it feel for you when you know you're in the zone singing those gospel sounds?
Oh, it really feels like I'm digging deep and I'm not just speaking, you know, physically, because I know that with those notes we have to use our diaphragm. But yeah, metaphorically speaking, I definitely think that digging deeper into, you know, who I am and what I believe in plays a huge part, not just in my music, but in my faith as well, in making me a stronger person as an individual, not just a teacher, but also, you know, a daughter, a sister, an auntie and a cousin. So, yeah, I think that plays a very important role.
And when you're writing your songs, because I know you said you love to do some songwriting, are you using faith to infuse into your music, or are there just sort of memories and stories that you like to write about in your songwriting?
Growing up, my first few songs I wrote were actually faith-based, and heavily influenced by the scripture as well. I would say more so now it's a part of my process. I wouldn't say it's necessarily explicit in my lyrical content, but it's definitely, you know, something that inspires, you know, the writing process and actually getting it down on paper.
Well, we have some quick-fire faith questions now, so it's going to loosen you up. We ask these to our artists every week, so you just tell me the first thing that comes up your mind. If you could collaborate with any gospel artist, who would it be and why?
The general answer would be Kirk Franklin, but if I were to go to the woman of gospel, probably Kira Sherd.
And do you play harp or horn if you had to choose?
Oh, I'd love to play a horn instrument. Yeah.
Why is that?
Oh, because the piano is different and I sing as well, and so I'd love to use my voice.
Do you have a most memorable favourite Sunday school song?
My God loves me.
Oh, can we have a little bit?
Just my God loves me and all the wonders I see. Mm-mm-mm. Yeah, that one.
Do you have a favourite Pacific gospel song?
Yes, The Lord Is My Light by Eddies, but I also love all of Brooke Fraser's material as well.
So, if you were to be a biblical character, who would it be and why?
Oh, toss up. Either Miriam, Moses' sister, because apparently she led the Israelites and was dancing and singing, and she was leading her crew of females with her and doing that. Or because I love animals and I have two dogs, probably Noah. He's an animal rescuer, so I love that.
Awesome. Okay, if I were to open up your phone, your mobile phone, and see your Spotify playlist, your YouTube playlist, what kind of songs would I be seeing from Grace?
Anything probably by Todd Delaney. I hope I've said his name right. Jay Moss, Anointed, Ramaya, a whole heap of gospel artists, Kirk Franklin, the likes of Israel Houghton. Yeah, just a general bunch of gospel artists, really.
Great. Well, we are going to plan a trip to the Holy Lands. So where are we going to go? Do you want to tell me? Do you have a favourite place?
Yeah, it's not like super amazing, but I'd love to go to the Red Sea and just be able to stand there and say,
deliver us, or yes. You shall pass. You know, just
and
like Moses did.
Something might open up.
Something like that.
Yeah. Oh, well, it's great having you on the show. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
We're coming to that time now where we get to do our soul session duet. So excited to jam this number with you, Grace. Would you like to introduce it for us?
Sure. Our duet song is Can't Give Up Now.
To have Grace Ikenasio in studio with us. We'll see you again next time. Take care. God bless.
Bye.
Soul Sessions.